With an aim to expand equitable access to play-based early childhood development and graduation for marginalized and ultra-poor refugee and host community, BRAC is implementing a dual-generational project in the West Nile region. The project provides early learning opportunities through play labs to 3 to 5 year old children with a play-based early learning model. The orientation workshop aims to help education stakeholders with supervision and activities in the early childhood development centers and to encourage communities to replicate the same in other areas.
We are calling this an illustrative workshop in that we have carried the classroom literally from the settlement where they operate and set it up here for them to have a feel, touch, play with the materials, interact with the teachers, and then after be able to ask questions as to why we are doing what we are doing.
Refresher trainings and also the ongoing mentoring and coaching by our field staff who visit these ECD centers on a weekly basis. Another important component of the play-based mode of learning is the community and parents' involvement and engagement. We involve this through the material development workshops where they're able to make local, contextualized, and no cost materials for these learners, both in the ECD centers or play labs and also back home, because learning doesn't only take place in our centers but also at home.
We used to have P7 dropouts who can still sustain their life, because if I left in P7 and I can be forced to make maybe 10 core handles in a week, that means I can survive.
Leaders believe the model will help change the mindset of both children and parents. They commended the caregivers on the conducive environment at the early childhood development centers.
You know, those days, parents assess how children can do better by, you know, you will assess your child out of either can do physical things or can go by other activities right from childhood.
The environment appears to become a lovely, approachable environment. Then thirdly, an environment where there is a display so that the child can choose at a certain time, even when the teacher is not there. There is a level of incidental learning. The child can choose to play with any material he will choose to without the help of the teacher.
Funded by Conrad N. Hilton Foundation, the project is providing integrated early childhood development and sustainable livelihood opportunities with a view to achieve long-term economic self-reliance. As a result, 34 early childhood development centers have been constructed in both Terego and Madiokolo districts, refugee settlements targeting over 4,000 learners and their parents from 700 households with livelihood options. Report by Robert Adiga for the news.